Hey, what's going on guys? Today I'm a bit late to the party. Plenty of photos of custom Nvidia cards are out in the wild right now and they look real nice. There's triple fan models, mini ITX models, factory OC models, and plastic. Lots of plastic. Sadly. Let's get started. Alright everybody, before we get started, I'm going to have a poll and a card on the upper right hand corner of this video. What should be my main GPU when I upgrade in a month? An aftermarket 1060 or aftermarket 480? I'll go over the results in a separate video. So the GTX 1060 so far has many confirmed cards, and we'll start with Asus. Firstly, we only have one picture of these two cards on the left here, the Turbo and the Dual 1060. Although if it's anything like the 1070 Dual just pictured here, then it'll look real nice. Next, we have the Asus Strix 1060. Video Cards has released an article detailing the specs for this model, and also they have plenty of pictures. We can see it's pretty large like the other three fan Strix GPUs also, and it comes with two HDMIs, two display ports, and a single dual link DVI-D. So we're not seeing DVI die just yet, thankfully. Then we have more pictures detailing RGB lighting capabilities and this massive heat pipe and heatsink that'll hide behind the fans. Asus then touts their own game booster software, which looks like an overclocking software, but I'd probably still use MSI Afterburner. Last picture here is specs, and I'll leave it here if you'd like to pause on that. Alright, now we have the Zotac 1060 Mini from Saber PC, which at the time of writing this has been removed from their website, so all we have is a base clock and a boost clock. I will say that if any of you are looking at modifying an existing PC of yours, you should take a look at mini GPUs like this, because they will most likely fit into a lot of smaller pre-built PCs. Please though, if you decide on going that route, consider that you'll probably need to upgrade your PSU as well, because this is going to need at least a 6-pin, possibly an 8-pin power connector, and most basic PSUs will not have that. Okay, next we've got the GTX 1060 Amp from Zotac, and this is also a shorter card sporting a 2-fan design, and what looks to be a metal cooler. We can hope, but a lot of GPUs these days are coming with backplates, and we can't tell on this one if it has a backplate or not. All we get here is a boost and base clock, along with the front of the GPU, sadly. Next is this PNY GPU, single picture, nice looking box. Once again we get DVI and really sleek looking fans on what looks to be a plastic cooler. This is the only picture we get, so no specs, and it doesn't look to have a backplate either. Lastly, we have two more Zotac models, and I will say the one on the left is my favorite of all these pictured in the video. It's the GTX 1060 PGF, and it looks to have a matte paint finish on it, and with these cool looking fan covers, I really like it. The model on the right is the Zotac GTX 1060X Gaming Edition. Something interesting to note about it is that it has two DVI outputs, unlike the others that we've seen so far. Most likely these are DVI-D and DVI-I dual link, so we'll still be able to use our VGA monitors with a passive adapter if you have one. If you don't have one, they're cheap, as you can see on Amazon right here. I think this is the first time that this has been pictured on a 1060, so there we go. Alright guys, thanks for watching the video. As always, all relevant links will be in the description below, so you can check them out for yourselves. Anyways, if you like the content in this format, then subscribe and drop a like. If you hated my voice or something, then please drop a dislike and comment down below on what you'd like to see improved. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.